إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. So in continuing with أصول السنة, the explanation of أصول السنة, أصول السنة of Imam Ahmad رحمه الله, and explanation by our noble Sheikh, Sheikh Rabi' bin Hadi al-Madkhali, Hafidhahullah. And we reached the section of Al-Qadr. The author, Imam Ahmad rahimahullah, said, وَمِنَ السُّنَّةِ اللَّازِمَةِ الَّتِي مَنْ تَرَكَ مِنْهَا خَصْلَةِ. And from the sunnah, which is lazima, which is incumbent, that which مَنْ تَرَكَ مِنْهَا خَصْلَةِ, if anyone takes away or leaves away, sorry, a khasla, a part of it, لَمْ يَقْبَلْهَا وَيُؤْمِنُ بِهَا لَمْ يَكُنْ مِنْ أَهْلِهَا لَمْ يَقْبَلْهَا. He doesn't accept it, even though he believes in it, he doesn't accept it. لَمْ يَكُنْ مِنْ أَهْلِهَا, he's not from it, he's not from the people of sunnah, he's not from the people of sunnah. Imam Ahmad says الإيمان بالقدر, from it is, يعني from this this part of iman, which if you leave a khasla from it, then you will find you're not from its people. So iman has six pillars. All of it we must believe in, and the details of how to believe in these six pillars. So the iman he's speaking about here, the khasla here is al-iman bil qadr, khayrihi wa sharrihi. The iman of al-qadr, of the pre-decree, both for the good as well as the bad. Wa tasdiqu bil ahadithiha, and to trust and to accept the ahadith, those narrations that are mentioned regarding al-qadr, pre-decree, predestination. والإيمان بها, and to believe in it. لا يقال لما, it is not to be said why, لما كذا ولما كذا, why is this and why is that, regarding the affairs of al-qadr, and also regarding the nasus of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم and the kitab Allah. It's not to be said why, لماذا أو لما, ولا كيف, nor is it to be said how, unless you are told. If you are not told, then this is hikmah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we desist. We stop where the Sahaba radiallahu anhu stopped, as Umar Abdul Aziz rahimahullah said, who died 101 Hijriya, قِفْ حَيْثُ وَقَفَ الْقَوْمُ فَإِنَّهُمْ عَنْ عِلْمٍ وَقَفُوا. Stop where the Sahaba stopped, the people stopped in the Sahaba, for they stopped upon knowledge. Don't precede them, don't go beyond them, for their understanding is the understanding that we are ordered and commanded to follow. إِنَّمَا هُوَ التَّصْدِيقُ وَالْإِيمَانُ بِهَا. So therefore, the affair of Qadr is an affair of accepting, affirming, and believing in it without rejection, without questioning, and without asking how. So Shaykh Rabi حفظه الله, he says, after he quoted the first part of Imam Ahmad رحمه الله's statement, he said, انتبهوا لهذا, be careful of this and pay attention to this. هذه الفقرة مهمة جدا, this فقرة, this part is very important, he says. الإمام أحمد سيصف لنا أصولا. Imam Ahmad is now describing to us أصول, foundations, fundamentals. من ترك شيئا منها, whoever leaves a part from it, a section from it, فليس من أهل السنة, then he is not to be from أهل السنة. And what we're talking about, the fundamentals of this deen, Tawheed, Aqeedah, those affairs. So pay attention to that. We're not talking about furu', In matters of fraud, there may be differences of opinion amongst the ulama. But in aqidah, Shaykh Rabi Abu Dhabi says, يعني يخرج عن دائرة السنة إلى البدعة. If you leave the fundamentals, you come out of sunnah and you enter bid'ah. Because these are fundamentals. There's clear text. Clear text. And you go away from them, then you have fallen into innovation. تنبهوا لهذا. تنبهوا لهذا. Pay attention to this. ومن السنة اللازمة التي من ترك منها خصلة فإذا تركها كلها. How about if he, as Sheikh Rabi says, he left all of it. He left all the fundamentals. يعني if you just leave one of the fundamentals, you fall into bid'ah. How about if you leave all of it? All of the fundamentals. نعم. As some of the Ahl Bid'ah, you find, يعني from their foundations is corrupt. Their foundation is built upon corruptness. Qardawi, for example, we mentioned that example. His foundation is a command from Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. A command is only necessitates a preference, istihbab. Look, from the foundation is corrupt. How do you expect the rest of the yani ijtihad that he has and the rest of the position that he holds to be correct? If the foundation is corrupt, of course it's going to fall into bid'ah. This is why you find Shaykh al-Albani rahimahullah, before he yani if somebody comes to see him from the innovators and they want to make jidal upon yani, and he Shaykh al-Albani rahimahullah yani argues with them with beautiful preaching, subhanallah, from the first thing he mentions is, where do we accept our reference point? As he said, as he established in Halillahi Makan, in those tapes which are translated and you can find them, inshallah, available. Where is Allah? The first thing that he established is, what are the reference points that we go back to? The Quran, the Sunnah, and the understanding of the companion. It may seem so simple, but by Allah, you find that the innovators, this is where they fall, in the most fundamental of affairs. And likewise in his debate or in his arguing with ways that is better with the Mu'tazila, the Afraq al-Mu'tazila. And that's how the tapes are called, Afraq al-Mu'tazila. The chicks of the Mu'tazila, yani the youngsters amongst the Mu'tazila. First and foremost, he established again the same methodology. We go back to قال الله, قال رسول الله, قال الصحابة. As Ibn al-Qayyim rahimullah said, العلم قال الله قال رسوله قال صحابة ليس بالتمويه ما العلم نصبك لخلاف سفاهة بين الرسول وبين رأي فلان أو فقيه. Knowledge is what Allah and His Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said and what the companion said. This is knowledge, and it is foolishness, he said, that you compare the statement of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم with anyone else, whether if it's faqih or fulan, anyone is foolishness. Why? Because this is Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. يعني وما ينطق عن الهوى. He doesn't speak of his own accord. Whatever he gave you, take it. وَمَا أَتَاكُمْ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوهُ وَمَا نَهَاكُمْ عَنُهُ فَانْتَهُوا. Whoever forbids you from, then keep away from. Shaykh Rabi' Abdullah is just as all the other ulama, like Shaykh Al-Albani rahimahullah and other than Shaykh Al-Albani rahimahullah, all of them establishing the usul, the fundamentals for where we take our deen, and we accept it without rejection. إِذَا لَمْ يَكُنْ مِنْ أَهْلِ السُّنَّةِ يَكُونُ مِنْ أَهْلِ الْبِدَعِ وَالضَّلَالِ. So if he's not from Ahlul Sunnah, that is from the people of innovation and misguidance. وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ. And we seek refuge in Allah from that. وَأَنْتُمْ تَعْرِفُونَ أَنَّ الْبِدْعَةَ تَنْقَسِمُ إِلَى كَبَائِرٍ وَصَغَائِرٍ. And you know that bid'ah is split into the major bid'ah, or the greater bid'ah, and the lesser bid'ah, if you like, the minor bid'ah. The major and the minor bid'ah. نعم. وَإِلَى شِرْك وَإِلَى الْحَاد. And also bid'ah, you may find a bid'ah in aqidah, which first takes a person into shirk, and it takes a person into ilhad, atheism. And Shaykh Muhammad al-Banna hafidhullah said something similar to that as well, where he said you have to understand the difference between bid'ah in aqidah and bid'ah in amal, in action. So a bid'ah in action, like you find a person doing using the tasbih beads. Did Rasulullah s.a.w. use these beads? No, so we don't use them. Rasulullah s.a.w. used to use his right hand and make tasbih with his right hand. Somebody may say, but I can't count 100 times. Subhanallah. You can't count. Allah is the hasib. Allah is the one who's going to count for you. You do your ijtihad following the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. وَأَحَبُّ أَعْمَالِ اللَّهِ أَدْوَمُهَا وَإِنْقَلْ. The most beloved actions towards Allah are those that are few, that are continuous, even though they are little. So long as you are according to the sunnah, trying your best, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bless the action, even though it's little, even though it's less. That's why Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, he used to say, اقتصادٌ في السنة خيرٌ من اجتهادٍ في بدعة. Economizing upon the sunnah is better than doing ijtihad, striving your utmost upon bid'ah. Sheikh Falah, when he came, goes past the mosque, what does he say? He said, MashaAllah, big mosque in London, big mosque. No, that belongs to the Brelvis. And then what does the Sheikh say? Allahu musta'an. Next one, big mosque. No, that belongs to the Sufis. Next one, that's the one belongs to the Tablighis. Each time, he says, Allahu musta'an. So much effort and so much effort wasted. So much money and so much money wasted upon bid'ah. نسأل الله سلامة. وإلى الشرك وإلى الإلحاد. So bid'ah can make you fall into shirk as well. If it is bid'ah in aqidah. Bid'ah in i'tiqad, somebody innovates and goes to the graves, as Sheikh Muhammad Ibn explained. Somebody does tawaf over the graves, believing that the person in the grave can help you, and he is the one who can remove harm and bring about good. This is bid'ah in aqidah now. Bid'ah in aqidah. The man is falling into shirk. And shirk in rububiyyah, the greatest of all shirk. Shirk rububiyyah. Even the kuffar of Quraysh did not have shirk in rububiyyah. They had shirk in uluhiyyah. وَلَا إِن سَأَلْتَهُ مَنْ خَلَقَ السَّمَوَاتِ الْأَرْضِ لَيَقُولُنَّ اللَّهِ. If you ask him, who created the heavens and the earth, they will say Allah. Shaykh Rabbi Hafidh Allah continues, he says, وَإِلَى بَلَاء كَمَا يَقُولُ ابْنُ الْقَيِّمِ رَحِمَهُ اللَّهِ الْبِدْعَةُ مُشْتَقَّةٌ مِنَ الْكُفْرِ وَآلِيَةٌ إِلَيْهِ. So bid'ah is derived and it stems from disbelief and calls to it and leads to it. وَالْبِدْعَةُ تَقُومُ عَلَى الْهَوَى. Bid'ah, يعني, it is established upon desires. It's not based upon قال الله قال رسول الله. Because bid'ah is something new, something invented. As Imam al-Tartushi al-Maliki rahimahullah, he wrote in his book Al-Hawadith wal-Bid'ah, he said, أصل هذه الكلمة من اختراع وهو شيء يحدث من غير أصل سبق ولا مثال احتدي ولا ألف مثله. That this, the أصل of this word is invention, and it is something that is there without, it is something which is invented, it is something which occurs, وهو شيء يحدث, without an أصل, without a previous foundation, without something that can be traced back to the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, nor something that can be derived from him, nor something happened at his time like this. So they bring something new that wasn't there at the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is what bid'ah is, as Imam Tartushi rahimahullah mentioned, and this is all derived from the nusus, as in the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلْ مَا كُنْتُ بِدْعًا مِنَ الرُّسُلِ. Say, I am not a new thing in terms of the messengers. Oh, the Rasul ﷺ was not new. His message was not new. His message was the same as all the other prophets. وَلَقَدْ بَعَثْنَا فِي كُلِّ أُمَّةٍ رَسُولًا أَنْ يَعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ وَاجْتَنِبُوا الطَّاغُوتَ. And we have ordained, we have sent to every nation a messenger. What was they called? أَعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ. Worship Allah and keep away from the false deities.
Bismillah. الحمد لله رب العالمين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده رسوله أما بعد. شيخ ربيع حفظ الله continues in explaining أصول السنة of Imam Ahmad, page 16. He says, والبدعة تقوم على الهوى والضلال. بدعة is established upon هوى, desires, and ضلال, misguidance. As Allah says in the Quran in Surah Al-Jathiyah, أفرأيت من اتخذ إله هواه. Have you not seen the one who takes his ilah, his deity, as his god? He takes his, يعني, hawa, his desires as his deity. وَأَضَلَّهُ اللَّهُ عَلَىٰ عِلْمٍ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala misguided him upon knowledge. وَخَتَمَ عَلَىٰ سَمْعِهِ وَقَلْبِهِ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sealed his hearing, his heart. وَجَعَلَ عَلَىٰ بَصْرِهِ غِشَاوَةً. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made for his sight غشاوة, a covering so she can't see. فَمَنْ يَهْدِيهِ مِنْ بَعْدِ اللَّهِ. So who can guide him after Allah? Allah misguided him. Why? Because he's upon هَوَى. وَمَنْ أَضَلْ مِمَّنْ تَبَعَ هَوَاهُ بِغَيْرِ هُدًى وَلَا كِتَابٍ مُنِيرٍ.
And who is more astray, as in the other verse, than one who is upon desires. He follows his own desires without a book, without guidance, and without a clear book. Who's more astray than that? Subhanallah. فَنَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ, he says, مِنْ اِتِّبَاعِ الْهَوَى. We seek refuge from following desires. Wallahi, ya ikhwan. We seek refuge from following desires. And this is why we must every morning, when we get up, make out the adhkar. And in the evening, do our adhkar. And just as Rasulullah was careful in his sujood, يَا مُقَلِّبَ الْقُلُوبِ ثَبِّتْ قَلْبِ عَلَى دِينَكَ. It's easy for a person to fall. It's easy for a person to deviate. It's easy for a person to sin. It's easy for a person to follow shaitan. And Allah says, وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا خُطُوَاتِ الشَّيْطَانِ إِنَّهُ لَكُمْ عَدُوٌ مُّبِينٌ. Don't follow the footsteps of shaitan, for he's a clear enemy. Shaykh Rabi Hafidhullah says, وَلِهَذَا سَمَّ أَهْلُ السُّنَّةِ أَهْلَ الْبِدَعِ بِأَهْلِ أَهْوَى. This is why you find أهل السنة have called the people of innovation as people of desires. Because they don't accept the text. They don't accept قَالَ اللَّهِ. They don't accept قَالَ رَسُولِ Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and they don't accept Qala Sahaba. They don't accept that. فَنَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ. And you may find them cut and paste. You may find half a verse, half a hadith, or misquoted, or misunderstood hadith or verse, and they build their deen upon that. فَنَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنْ اتِّبَاعِ الْهَوَى. وَاللَّهِ نَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنْ اتِّبَاعِ الْهَوَى. Wallahi. That's a great statement from Shaykh Rabi'. Because there are some, maybe they follow their desires. They don't know why they are doing certain actions. They just do them because of another person is doing it. So he's a blind follower. As the Messenger said, لَا تَكُنْ إِمْعَهْ. Don't be a blind follower. إِنْ أَحْسَنَ النَّاسِ أَحْسَنْتُمْ وَإِنْ أَسَاءَ النَّاسِ أَسَأْتُمْ. If the people are good, then you're good. And if the people are bad, then you're bad. Blind follower, huh? Clear. Just because my friend did this, I'm doing it. Just because my sheikh said so, I'm going to do it. Yani, not following the dalil, not following the proofs, just because you're a blind follower. That's all it is. Im'a. And maybe you think that you are, mashallah, a hero, a brave person. You have reached, mashallah, manhood. Because you think that your opinion is different than everybody else's. So, mashallah, tabarakallah, you have reached that position. But you're still a blind follower. You're still an imma. Because you're not following the dalil from the a'imma. You are following your desires. فَنَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنْ اتِّبَاعِ الْهَوَى. And we used to complain much about the people of madhahib, the blind followers of the madhahib. And nowadays, it is not far away to say there are blind followers, not of the madhahib of the past, but there are blind followers of scholars. Allah says, فَاتَّبِعُوا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, فَاسْأَلُوا أَهْلَ الذِّكْرِ. Plural. All of them are our brothers. We love all of them. And nowadays you have blind followers. Just this one, and that is my marji, and that is it. نَسْأَلُ اللَّهَ سَلَامًا. So how far are you from the أهل المذاهب? وَنَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنْ اتِّبَاعِ الْهَوَى. وَأَيُّ اللَّهِ. وَلِهَذَا سَمَّ أَهْلُ السُّنَّةِ أَهْلَ الْبِدَعِ بِأَهْلِ الْأَهْوَاءِ. لِأَنَّهُمْ خَالَفُوا دِينَ اللَّهِ. Because they oppose the deen of Allah. وَاتَّبَعُوا أَهْوَاءَهُمْ. And they follow their desires. وَهَؤُلَاءَ مِثْلُ الْخَوَارِجِ. They are similar to the Khawarij. So don't think that you are free from falling into any of these deviations. If you think that you are safe from falling into any of these deviations, then you have not understood the da'wah to Salafiyyah. You have not understood the deen. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, without His mercy and without His tawfiq, without Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protecting you and guiding you, wallahi, you are misguided. Without Allah, man ant? Without Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who is al-hadi, the one who is the guide, the one who الذي يحول بين المرء وقلبه, the one who comes between the person and his heart. As the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, قلوب العباد بين أصبعين من أصابع الرحمن يقلبها كيف يشاء. The hearts of the servants are between the two fingers of Ar-Rahman. He changes it how he wills. So you're deserving of misguidance, you'll be misguided. You're deserving of guidance, Allah will give it to you. And don't think you will get away with oppression. And don't think you will get away with misguidance. And don't think you get away with following your desires. How you treat others, you will be treated. كما تدين تدان كما تدين تدان. As the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said, just as you treat others, you will be treated. Just as you treat others, you will be treated. Look at Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم's example. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, just by looking at his face, subhanAllah, people will become Muslim. Abdullah ibn Salam, when he saw the face of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, I do not think this face is the face of a liar. He became a Muslim. He saw the face of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, Aslam. Nas'Allah salama. Look at that. Allahu Akbar. Nowadays, نسأل الله يعني يحفظنا. Nowadays, we have to follow that example of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, being welcoming to others, being guides, giving nasiha to others, advising them. الدين نصيحة كما قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. I'm going to read to you here a section from Al-Wabil al-Sayyib. When we were one time, we visited one of the mashayikh in Medina, and subhanallah, the mashayikh in Medina, hafidhahum Allah, there are many, alhamdulillah, and they are busy teaching the people the ilm al-nafi'. And even in the general sittings, when you go and you have a holiday, say for 1 week, you have a holiday, alhamdulillah, you can finish books with them. The last holiday, which was the head of the year, alhamdulillah, Shaykh Abdul Bukhari, he did a ha'iyya of Ibn Abi Dawood, and he finished it, alhamdulillah, in 5 days. And just before we came, there was lectures, durus, I mean, for 2 weeks. Alhamdulillah, in those 2 weeks, books of imma of the past were taught and they were finished. And this is a blessing with the ulama. They busy the people with ilm al-nafi'. Wallah. Anyway, went to visit one of the sheikhs in Medina, and then he brought out Wabil al-Sayyib ibn al-Qayyim, and he started reading. And this is about treating, how you treat others, you will be treated. Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah says, and this is in the section, it's on page 70 in one of the volumes, in one of the prints, and in the other print is page 56. وهو سبحانه وتعالى رحيم يحب الرحماء. And he سبحانه وتعالى is رحيم. Allah is رحيم, is kind, and he loves the رحماء, and he loves those who are kind and gentle. وإنما يرحم من عباده الرحماء. And Allah has mercy upon those of his slaves who are رحماء, who are merciful. الله أكبر. And this is in line with the hadith of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, الراحمون يرحمهم الرحمن يوم القيامة. Authentic hadith where the Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم said, the rahimun, those who have mercy, those who have mercy on يوم القيامة, Allah will have mercy on them. Allahu Akbar. So isn't it from mercy to know the قواعد of Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah, such that you know how to implement the deen of Allah? You know about bid'ah, you know how to implement bid'ah. You know how to implement what is bid'ah, and you know how to implement يعني, the conditions of fulan being a hizbi or fulan being a mubtadi'. Isn't that from rahmah, from mercy, to know these affairs? So you yourself don't fall into bid'ah yourself of saying something is bid'ah when it's not bid'ah. That statement itself is bid'ah. أليس كذلك؟ وهو ستير حب من يستر على عباده. And Allah is ستير, the one who covers the faults, and he covers the faults upon his slaves. Allah, just as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala covers the faults upon his slaves, yani those faults that are to do with the person, between him and Allah. As for those innovations that he comes out with, then they are not to be concealed. If somebody openly comes out with innovations and that, they are to be refuted openly. As Shaykh bin Baz rahimahullah says in one of the Risa'il, in refuting Shu'aib Arnaut in his ta'wilat that he has, he says that it's not to be said. Shaykh bin Baz rahimahullah says, it is not to be said that why didn't you advise him secretly? Andur. But rather, his mistakes were open, and so the mistakes were refuted openly. Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah says, wa'afuun. Allah is forbearing, forgiving. Afuun. Yani he overlooks. Allah overlooks. Wa huwa afuun yuhibbu man ya'fu anhum. And Allah loves those who are also overlooking. Not always blaming. وَغَفُورٌ يُحِبُّ مَنْ يَغْفِرَ لَهُمْ. He's a ghafoor. Allah is merciful, forgiving. And He loves those who are also forgiven of others. Allahu Akbar. وَلَطِيفٌ يُحِبُّ اللَّطِيفُ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ. Allah is Latif and He loves the Latif from His slaves. Who's the Latif? What does the Latif mean? Latif has two meanings. Latif, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Mulk, وَهُوَ اللَّطِيفٌ خَبِيرٌ أَلَا يَعْلَمُ مَنْ خَلَقَ وَهُوَ اللَّطِيفُ الْخَبِيرٌ أَلَا يَعْلَمُ مَنْ خَلَقَ. Allahu Akbar. Doesn't the one who created knows what He created? And He is Al-Latif Al-Khabir. And He is Al-Latif Al-Khabir. What does Al-Latif mean? Sheikh Zayd bin Hadi Al-Madkhali, he says, Al-Latif has two meanings. Al-Latif means that Allah knows the most minute detail of the affairs. And that's why usually Al-Latif, the name Latif comes with Al-Khabir or Al-Alim. It comes with Al-Latif, comes with Al-Alim or Al-Khabir. Because Allah knows the most minute things in Surah Al-Luqman. يَا بُنَيَّ إِنَّهَا إِن تَكُمْ إِثْقَالَ حَبَّةٍ فَتَكُمْ فِي سَخْرَةٍ أَوْ فِي السَّمَوَاتِ أَوْ فِي الْأَرْضِ يَأْتِ بِهَا اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَطِيفٌ خَبِيرٌ. Again, Latif, Khabir. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Latif. He knows the minute details of the affairs. The minute details. This, subhanallah. As one of the mashayikh, Sheikh Muhammad Al-Aqil said, he knows the veins inside the ant. The blood moving inside the veins inside the ant. Allah is, subhanallah, hides Allah from imperfection. Allah knows, you may see the sea in front of you. Allah knows what's in the sea. The different types of species in the sea. And not only He knows that, and the details, but the affairs, and taking care of every single one of them. Subhanallah. And then I call Subhanallah. Subhanallah. Wallahi Subhanallah. Allah knows the heavens and what is in them. And you, Subhanallah. Allah says in one of the verses, He says, La khalqu as-samawati al-ard, the creation of the heavens and the earth is greater than the creation of an-nas, of mankind. We think we see all these people, mashallah, tabarakallah, we think it's many. But we haven't seen, we just seen a keyhole, khalas. Something very minute. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes care of what you do, what you see and what you don't see. فَلَا أُقُسِمُ بِمَا تُبْصِرُونَ وَمَا لَا تُبْصِرُونَ. So Allah swears by that which you see and that which you don't see. How great is that which you don't see? Allah is great. The millions of stars, the galaxies, the Milky Ways, the universe and the black hole, all of that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is aware and taking care of every single minute detail of His creation. Do you think Allah will not have mercy for you? Do you think Allah will not defend you if someone's oppressing you? Do you think Allah doesn't know the fitan that occurs? Allah is more jealous of His deen than you. Na'am. Allah Azza wa Jal, He knows the affairs, but this is a test for the people. Ibtila. أَحَسِبْتُمْ أَن تَدْخُلُوا الْجَنَّةِ أَحَسِبَ النَّاسُ أَن يُتْرَكُوا أَن يَقُولُوا آمَنَّا وَهُمْ لَا يُفْتَنُونَ وَلَقَدْ فَتَنَّ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ فَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ صَدَقُوا وَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ الْكَاذِبِينَ. Do you think that people will be left alone to say that what they only believe? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tested those before them and those who after them will be tested, so that Allah knows the truth for once from the liars. From the liars. Don't think this da'wah to Salafiyya is just something which is easy. You come into this blessed da'wah of following the Quran and Sunnah, there's going to be tests. Ibtila. Allah's going to test you. Test your eyes. You're going to be tested with your eyes, your tongue, your ears, your movements, the fitan that you are sebab of, the heart. Allah knows what's on the heart. Your hate, your love, and the actions of the heart, as Imam, in Tajrid Tawheed al-Mufid, Imam Maqrizi, Shafi'i Imam from the 8th century, he says a beautiful statement, wallah. He says Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He mentions in there about the actions of the limbs and the actions of the tongue, yani what you say, and the actions of the heart. And the actions of the heart are great and are very great indeed. And Shaykh Ubaid Hafidullah says, and there is no mustahabbat in the actions of the heart. The actions of the limbs, you have mustahabbat. Nawafil siyam, nawafil salah. Mustahabbat in the actions of the tongue. Doing dhikr, mustahab. And some of it is fard, like fatiha in salah. La salata liman lam yaqra' bi fatihatil kitab. but the actions of the heart are obligatory. All of them are obligatory. You have to have love for Allah. You can't love any others besides Allah. You have to hate for Allah's sake. You have to hope for Allah, to meet Allah. Whoever loves to meet me, Allah says, I'll love to meet him. Huh? من كان يحب لقائي كنت أحب لقائي أو كما قال رسول صلى الله عليه وسلم أو كما قال الله عز وجل في حديث قدسي. Whoever loves to meet me, I love to meet him. And likewise, Ibn al-Qayyim rahimullah says, so Latif has two meanings. The first one is Allah knows the minute details, and the second one, Allah is a beautiful, beautiful meaning. Allah. The second one, Sheikh Zayed bin Hadi al-Madkhali says, the second one means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes care of the affairs, the minute affairs of his slaves, even without them knowing. Allah. Even without you knowing that Allah is taking care of your affairs, Allah is taking care of your affairs. Because he's a Latif. He's taking care of your rizq when you don't even know. وَفِي السَّمَاءِ رِزْقُكُمْ وَمَا تُوْعَدُونَ. He's taking care of your life, your family, taking care of your children. Look at the one who died and he died righteousness. وَكَانَ أَبُوهُمَا صَالِحًا فَأَرَادَ رَبُّكَ إِنْ اسْتَخْرِجَ كَنْزَهُمَا رَحْمَةً مِنْ رَبِّكَ وَمَا فَعَلْتُ عَنْ أَمْرِي. Because the father was good, Allah took care of the children's wealth. Allah took care of them, and Allah will take care of you. You take care of his deen. As the hadith of Ibn Abbas, احفظ الله يحفظك. Guard Allah's duties and he will guard you. احفظ الله تجده تجاهك. And if you guard Allah's duties, you will find him in front of you. يعني helping you. احفظ الله تجده تجاهك. وإذا سألت فاسأل الله وإذا استعنت فاستعن بالله. And if you ask, ask Allah alone. And when you seek help from Allah alone. So Allah is a Latif with the one who's Latif. So you want to be يعني bold and arrogant and transgressing over others, and you want to show that you have something with evil speech, no balance in what you are saying, subhanallah. Do you think Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to be latif with you? Sallallahu salama. Sallallahu salama. And look at the next part he says. Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah says, وَيُبْغِضُ الْفَضَّ الْغَلِيظَ الْقَاسِ الْجَعْضَرِي. Subhanallah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Ibn al-Qayyim says, and Allah hates, yubghidu, bughd. Allah hates the fadh, al-ghaleed, al-qasi, the hard, rough, stern person. That person who's rough and hard and stern. Subhanallah. Is this how Rasulullah said? وَلَوْ كُنْتَ فَضًّا غَلِيظَ الْقَلْبِ لَمْ فَضُّ مِنْ حَوْلِكَ. And if you were like that, Allah said to Rasulullah ﷺ, if you were like that, then the people would have left you. Rasulullah ﷺ was not like that. Naam, there were certain cases, like when Umar al-Khattab, when he came in and knocked on the door hard, and he says, Ya Muhammad, he came hard before he became Muslim. And everybody was scared. They have a sahaba, they were scared. You know, Umar al-Khattab was coming into the house. One of the mashayikh, Rasulullah ﷺ also opened the door with so much firmness and that. And Umar al-Khattab became Muslim after that. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. Khalas. Na'am. Against itself, he used it in his place. But like this wasn't Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam's manner. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, even the Arab, the Bedouins, they would come to him, and sometimes they would pull his thobe hard. Ya Muhammad. And that's disrespect. The Sahabi say, Ya Rasulullah. They would come to him hard. Ya Muhammad. And yet Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would give them what they asked for. Have mercy for them. Subhanallah. Idfa' billati ahsan. Fa'idha alladhi baynaka wa baynahu adawatun ka'annahu waliyun hamim. So Allah dislikes and he hates that fadhl ghalidh al-qasi. So how is it? If you benefit, if you study your deen, it should humble you. If it doesn't humble you and it makes you more qasi, hard-hearted, stern, rough, this. What have you studied, ya akhi? Mada istafadta? Sallallahu salama. Knowledge which benefits you is knowledge which betters your character, makes you better Muslim. You come back and you're still hard and rough, hard on the people, this, that, this, mubtadi', this, what? Nasallahu salama, ya akhi. Where's your qawaid? Deenuna mabniyun ala al-masalihi fi dhar'iha fi jalbiha wa dhar'iha lil-qaba'ihi. وإذا تعدد عدد من المصالح يقدم الأعلى من المصالح وضده تزاحم المفاسد يرتكب الأدنى من المفاسد. Our deen is based upon maslaha, يا أخوان. Maslaha, bringing about good to the community, building the communities. It's not about destroying. So if there's two goods, you take the better of the two. And if you are forced to do any of the less, if there's two evils and you are forced to do one of them, the less of the two harms. إِلَّا مَنْ أُكْرِهَ وَقَلْبُهُ مُطْمَئِنٌ بِالْإِيمَانِ. As Allah says in the Quran, وَرَفِيقٌ يُحِبُّ الرِّفْقِ. Allah is a rafiq. يُحِبُّ الرِّفْقِ. Allah, great sayings. These great sayings by Ibn al-Qayyim, rahimahullah. رَفِيقٌ يُحِبُّ الرِّفْقِ. Allah is a rafiq. He is kind with the people. And He loves that. Gentleness. And He loves gentleness. وَحَلِيمٌ يُحِبُّ الْحِلْمِ. Halim. Now, halim is a very difficult word to translate. And there are many words that are attached to it. Hilm has come in many hadith. From the hadith where the Prophet ﷺ said, غُسْلُ يَوْمُ الْجُمْعَ وَاجِبٌ عَلَى كُلِّ مُحْتَلِمٍ. From the same word, غُسْلُ يَوْمُ الْجُمْعَ is obligatory upon every muhtalim, upon everyone who has reached that age where he has wisdom, age of puberty, has his ability to have wisdom. So hilm has different meanings. From it is wisdom, from it is forbearance, from it is gentleness and all of that. And it's comprehensive. يُحِبُّ, and that's from the Arabic dictionaries, يُحِبُّ مَنْ يَقْبَلْ مَعَاذِيرْ عِبَادَةً. Allah loves those who accept the excuses, and those who make mistakes and then they apologize, they excuse themselves for the mistakes that they have made. Allah loves those who accept those ones who accept the excuses are from others. Yani, if it's valid excuse, طبعاً, not something which is باطل. نعم. وَبَرٌ يُحِبُّ الْبِرُ. And Allah is the all righteous, and He loves those who are righteous. He loves righteousness and its people. وَعَدْلٌ يُحِبُّ الْعَدْلِ. And Allah is the all just, and He loves those who have justice. يُحِبُّ الْعَدْلِ. He loves justice. And qist, as Allah says in the other verse, قُلْ أَمَرَ رَبِّي بِالْقِسْطِ. Allah ordered to be balanced. Allahu Akbar. Not to have ghulu, not to have extremism. The Prophet ﷺ said to Ibn Abbas when he picked up the stones in Hajj time, when he picked the stone, it was too big, he said, إِيَّاكَ وَالْغُلُو. Or إِيَّاكُمْ وَالْغُلُو. Be warned that you fall into extremism. And ghulu is to go beyond the boundaries. Ghulu is to go and trespass beyond the boundaries. Because الحلال بين والحرام بين وبينهما أمور مشتبهات لا يعلمهن كثير من الناس فمن اتقى بالشبهات فقد استبرأ لدينه وعرضه ومن وقع في الشبهات وقع في الحرام. ألا إن لكل ملك حمى ألا إن حمى الله محارمه ألا إن في الجسد مضغة إذا صلحت صلح الجسد كله وإذا فسدت فسد الجسد كله ألا وهي القلب. I missed out the section. كالراعي يرعى حول الحمى يوشك أن يرتاع فيه. You find somebody comes close to the boundary of that which is haram, he comes close, it is fair that he will fall into it. Or he comes close to the boundary of the shubuhat, the doubtful matters, and he falls into the haram. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَقَابِلُ الْمَعَاذِيرُ. Allah accepts the excuse of those who bring their valid excuses. وَيُحِبُّ مَنْ يَقْبِلْ مَعَاذِيرِ عِبَادِهِ. I mentioned that. وَيُجَازِ عَبْدَهُ بِحَسْبِ هَذِهِ الصِّفَاتِ. Allah will recompense his slave according to these sifat he has. So if your sifat are those sifat Allah loves, then Allah will treat you like you are treating others. نعم. بِحَسْبِ هَذِهِ الصِّفَاتِ فِيهِ وُجُودًا وَعَدَمًا. So much as you have these sifat, present or not present, Allah will treat you like that. So don't be surprised that you fall into extremism and you isolate yourselves away from this blessed da'wah. You isolate yourself from the ulama. Don't be surprised that Allah will treat you like that as well. Don't be surprised, because nowhere you find those who isolated themselves in this da'wah, nowhere you find them succeeding. Fawzi al-Bahraini did it, and what happened in the end? Khalas, no one, you don't find anyone mention his name anymore now. After he isolated himself away from the ulama, away from this blessed manhaj, huh? And also insulting the ulama, you find what was the end result? The end result is isolated, and he's in his own little island. Nobody hears from him, nobody taken from him, except those who are already around him in his own little corner. And the same thing with Abu al-Hasan al-Ma'rabi. He was advised, he didn't accept the advice. And it's a matter of principles. Surely we should feel upset when the Sahaba have been spoken ill of. We should be upset, especially when it's done in such a way where after you've made tawbah, you say that they don't understand what sabba Sahaba is. After you've said that Sahaba has come, nas'Allah salama, and after you've insulted it. As for يعني, what is being spread on the net against Shaykh Ubayd Hafidhullah regarding Ka'b ibn Malik, Shaykh Ubayd Hafidhullah, his kalam is known regarding the Sahaba radiallahu anhu. Shaykh Ubayd Hafidhullah has يعني, in the past 40 years has been explaining the books of Aqidah in defense of the Sahaba radiallahu anhum. Shaykh Ubayd is known for that. So it is يعني, it is like somebody trying to look at the minute errors. And Shaykh Ubayd Hafidhullah says that this is what I have said. If Ka'b ibn Malik does not يعني, if he did not do tawbah, then he would have been يعني, he would have been يعني, destroyed. I can't remember the exact wording he used, but يعني, if he did not, Allah said that about Yunus alayhi salam, walaula na'am walaula na'am walaula an tadarakahu ni'matun min rabbik lana walaula an tadarakahu ni'matun min rabbi lanubida bil ara'i wa huwa madhmum. If he, Yunus alayhi salam, did not himself يعني, make tawbah and ask Allah for forgiveness, he would still be in the whale, in the belly of the whale, he would still be there. And if he did not say, La ilaha inni kuntu min al-dhalimin, he would still be there. Allah said that in the Quran. Does that mean, يعني, Shaykh Ubayd did not intend to insult Ka'b ibn Malik radiallahu anhu? This is something which he said. And he said that, Shaykh Salam Taymiyyah said that, which is similar. So I did not say anything which is different than what the Imam of the past have said. And this is something which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the same kind of wording, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala uses it in the Quran. So this is, Shaykh Ubayd Hafidhullah does not speak ill of the Sahaba radiallahu anhum. But unfortunately, there are some shabab, young shabab, who like to grab anything and then put it out on the net. And this is why shabab, لا يحسنون الدخول في الفتنة. They, يعني, do not. When they enter the fitna, they only corrupt it and they only harm themselves. So when the Shaykh has made his excuse and he mentioned his excuse, he said, I don't mean that. Well, and it's not like Abu al-Hasan, when he himself says they don't know what sab al-Sahaba is. And the clear sab of the Sahaba, clear sab, when he says that even the Sahaba didn't have husn al-dhan, and he criticizes Abu Sa'id al-Khudri. Even the Sahaba rushed to make judgments, and he criticized Osama bin Zayd when he killed the mushrik. Even the Sahaba, and he always making quotes against the Sahaba. Nas'Allah salama. So we don't follow that way of the Rawafid and that way of Sabba Sahaba. Fa'idha dukira ashabi famsiku. When my companions are mentioned, then withhold. Said, Warathatul Anbiya. They are inheritors of the Prophets. Innal Anbiya lam yuwarithu dinaran wala darhaman. The Anbiya, the Prophets, they don't leave behind dinars nor dirhams. ولكن ورثوا العلم. They leave behind knowledge. They don't leave behind wealth, ya akhwan. They leave behind knowledge. فمن أخذها أخذ بحظ وافر. So whoever gains it, gains a great treasure. Wallahi is a great treasure. To take knowledge from the ulama. And to take the adab from the ulama. The manners. To take the adab and the samt from the ulama. The samt. Being silent. As-samtu salama. As the Salaf used to say. As-samtu salama. That silence. As-samtu salama. In it there is salama. In it there is يعني security for that person. طبعاً if it is something haram, you don't speak about it. You don't keep quiet about it. If it's in front of you, change the munkar if you are able. As in the hadith of Abi Sa'id al-Khudri, فمن يعني فما رأى منكم منكرا فليغير بيده فإن لم يستطع فبلسانه فإن لم يستطع فبقلبه وذلك أضعف الإيمان. نعم. This is something which is يعني established. However, in most cases, يعني it is required that you have some adab. And then you have some samt. In most cases, you have, especially in front of the alim, especially in front of issues which are far greater than our ability, especially in front of those things which we are not worthy of entering. But however, we find many of the youngsters, unfortunately, they enter affairs which they themselves can't handle. And in the end, they only harm themselves. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, And he warns us from this. He warns us from entering that which you don't have knowledge of. وَلَا تَكْفُوا مَا لَيْسَ لَكَ بِهِ عِلْمٍ. Don't enter into that which you have no knowledge. إِنَّ السَّمْعَ وَالْبَصَرَ وَالْفُؤَادَ. For indeed the hearing, the sight, and the heart, كُلُّ أُولَٰئِكَ كَانَ عَنْهُ مَسْؤُولًا. All of it you are responsible over. So how is it the person who becomes a farfar? How is it for a farfar? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa said that the most hated, as Aisha radiallahu anha mentioned, the most hated upon the amongst the people are the Ahl al-Jidal, the people who are argumentative. The most hated people towards Allah, in the sight of Allah, are the argumentative people. And you find them on the internet, wallah. You find them on the internet. The most argumentative people. Instead of reading the Quran and reading one juz a day and trying to make dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and try to guard their tongue and guard their hearts and guard their limbs, what do? They enter into that which they have no knowledge of. And they enter into that which will only harm them. It will not harm the ulama. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لَا يَضُرُّكُمْ مَنْ ضَلَّ إِذَا هَتَدَيْتُمْ. No harm can come from you from those who stray if you are guided. إِلَى اللَّهِ مَرْجِعُكُمْ فَيُنَبِّئُكُمْ بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ. To Allah is going to be your return. And He will tell you all that you used to do. So know that you are behind the screen. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is basir. Allah is al-sami' and Allah is al-alim. And know that the difference between al-sami' and al-alim is great indeed. Indeed, Allah is al-sami' but alim is more shamil than sami'. Because alim, as Shaykh ibn Uthaymeen rahimahullah says, because al-sami' as Shaykh ibn Uthaymeen rahimahullah says in his tafsir of Surah Al-Hujurat, al-sami' is to do with the masmu'at. But al-alim is to do with everything. Alim is to do with everything. The masmu'at. That which is seen. And is to do with that which is hidden. And that which is apparent. And that which is in secret. And that which is what you do in front of people. And that which you hold and conceal in your heart. Na'am. Allah says, يَعْلَمُ خَائِنَةَ الْأَعْيُنِ وَمَا تُخْفِي الصُّدُورِ. Allah knows the deception in the eyes of the person. You don't know it. Maybe the person is deceiving you. He's got deception in his eyes. That's Allah salama. Deception in his eyes. Allah knows that. يَعْلَمُ خَائِنَةَ الْأَعْيُنِ وَمَا تُخْفِي الصُّدُورِ. And He knows further than that. He knows what the hearts contain. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Luqman, يَا بُنَيَّ إِنَّهَا إِنْ تَكُمْ مِثْقَالَ حَبَّةٍ مِنْ خَرْدَلٍ فَتَكُمْ فِي سَخْرَةٍ أَوْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ أَوْ فِي الْأَرْضِ يَأْتِ بِهَا اللَّهُ. Allah will bring it out. Allah will bring that atoms action, atoms weight of an action. If it is in the stone, in a rock, or it is in the heavens or in the earth, you try and hide it, Allah will bring it out. So no, don't enter that which you will regret afterwards. Don't enter that which you will regret afterwards. That which will only harm you rather than benefit you. So as-samtu salama la shak wa la raib, especially in those affairs which are not for us. What time is salah? 8:30. No. We stop there inshallah and continue after the salah. No.